Also, again, you come to church service for some reason. If you've got a testimony you would like to give, if you've got a song you would like to sing, please get up and give it for the Lord.
I put these glasses on there.
like to have a new body, that I can eat Little Debbie cakes, ice cream. I don't know. Y'all let me have that dream that the marriage supper of the Lamb, it's just going to have stacks of Nutty Bars, peanut butter cake. I don't care if it's steak and taters or not. I just want all the bad stuff that we can. Amen. Ready for her now? Sister Jamie, you guys got a treat. She ain't sung over here in a long time. Where is she at? There she is, Sister Jamie. You guys pray for her as she comes up here to sing. And if you got a song or a testimony this evening, again, this is the church service that you came to worship God. So don't you leave here if God puts something on your heart or mind this morning. Don't you leave here until you give it for the Lord.
I just want to say a little something. This week I had someone contact me about singing for their anniversary and kind of put me on the spot, and I was a little reluctant, and they said, please, it's my 20-some year anniversary. And I couldn't say no because I thought I couldn't think about other than me and Jerry, you know, our anniversary and like what that would mean to me. And she said, all we want is some gospel music for our anniversary. I thought, man, how can you say no to that? I mean, just gospel music, that's all you want? And she said, we've got everything else and we're happy together, that's all we want. And Jerry had given her a CD of us, and she said, you might think I'm just saying this, but we listen to that all the time. And I said, well, I'm so glad that that touches you, that it blesses you, that's what it was meant for. I said, I don't know where I'm going to start. I don't sing without him. And she said, just give what you got. And I kind of thought, God, are you setting me up for this? Are you putting me out here like that? Because you know I wasn't going to go on my own. So it's like he was kind of putting me on the spur of the moment. And I thought, well, how am I going to go and just randomly just start singing? And seen Justin out at a ball game with the kids, and I said, is there any way that you could help me with this? I said, you know, just at least just get me started, just hit the key and just let me be able to start. And I said, I know this is putting you on the spur of the moment as it is me. And he said, sure, I'd love to help you. And it touched us yesterday to touch them and bless them.
Yeah.
But we're going to sing, we sang this song yesterday, I Held On. And I think this song is more fitting now than it's ever been in my life. Because when you don't know your next step, and you don't know what tomorrow holds, all you can do is hold on and let God take care of the rest. So we're going to try to sing this song. You ask me how it is that I'm still standing. You wonder how I made it through this storm. I can boast of any special powers. There's no secret, I just held on to God, and I held on till the storm was over.
Yeah.
I don't claim to be a hero, and I don't have all the answers, but I held on till the storm was over. Because I'm good, not because I'm great, not because I'm strong, but I held on. I can tell you the things are finally happening. I've got blessings I can call my own. Many times I wondered if I would make it, while wondering, I just kept holding on and I held on till the storm was over. I don't claim to be a hero, and I don't have all the answers, but I held on till the storm was over. Not because I'm good, not because I'm great, not because I'm strong, but I held on till the storm was over. A hero, and I don't have all the answers, but I held a home till the storm was over. Not because I'm good, not because I'm great, not because I'm strong, not because I'm good, not because I'm great, not because I'm strong, oh, not because I'm good, not because I'm great, not because I'm strong, but I held on.
Christ said, make the desires of your heart be known. So I'm going to try to sing this. I love this song. May not be the best. I did you, Lord, like a flower in the sunshine. Make it without me, Lord, but I can't make it.
church one? That newer one?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
They happy to.
Where's the babies?
Huh?
Where's the babies?
Yeah, let them come up here. Yeah.
Come on, William, we all see them. Yeah, Timber.
Come on, baby. Y'all come see
me. All right, Nellie Bell.
All right.
Here.
I guess he's
Nellie.
I'm not the
head. That's
not
bad.
Y'all pray for me. This is a really hard song to sing. I struggle with it, but I love the words to it. And I love that the kids get up here and help me with it. So just pray for me. Guys ready? I'll get pin one. Sometimes I fall. Time is right now.
That's bad right there. Amen. I love listening to those babies sing. I had a pastor when I was growing up, y'all might know him, Josh Hall. Man, he's a good one. He'd always say, Brother Rods, he said, you just get up there and haul off and let her rip.
Let her rip.
Them babies got them microphones. That's the best sounding thing you ever heard in your life. They know them parts and they sing them so good this morning. We're awful proud of our babies here at this church. Woe be unto anybody who ever hurts them. We love them so much. We got another special singer. Miss Williamson, would you care to come for us today? Man, we're truly blessed. And you know my saying, Brother Donnie, you just get ready. Because I say as long as we sing, that's as long as he gets to preach. So, y'all pray for him this morning. Sorry, you take your time, sissy. We'll wait on you. Thank you very much.
Do I just want to get this one? This one might be okay.
You can hold it. If you want that one.
It don't matter.
We want to make sure everybody hears you.
You fix it. I just want to say I love the Lord this morning. And as always, I thank him for blessings of life, every blessing that he bestows upon me. I don't know her name, but she's here. She can stand. I don't know. She was at our church not too long ago, and I sang this song. And she said, when you come to Canada, I want you to sing a song for me. So anyway, it's a hard song to sing, but it's a good song. It's called One Pair of Hands. And when I sing this song, I think about the many things that God has done with one pair of hands. So y'all pray for me. I'll do my best. One pair of hands formed the mountains. One pair of hands formed the sea. One pair of hands made the sun and the moon. Every bird, every flower, every tree. One pair of hands formed the valleys, the ocean, the river, and the sand. Those hands are so strong, so when life goes wrong, put your faith into one pair of hands. One pair of hands healed the sick. One pair of hands raised the dead. Those hands, they were nailed to a tree. Those hands are so strong, so alive, goes wrong. Put your faith into one pair of hands. Those hands are so strong, so when life goes wrong.
so much, sis. Mm. That was beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Now, before we get Brother Donnie up here, I think the deacons would like to come up. They got a little something to do this morning. That means you boys. We'll go with the second service. Turn that down.
It's been a long time.
Yeah. Yeah.
Pray for me.
We will.
I really need it.
We love you, Sissy. And all of you, nobody knows what it's like to lose a spouse, a husband, or a wife. So those of you that have, pray especially hard for one another. And the Sissy, the Spirit will help you. And I don't know if it works by that, what you're talking about, but I know, I do know that when you called, Jesus said that he would never leave us and never forsake us, but yet he would send a comforter to help us. And that's exactly what that spirit is. And we love you and we're praying for you. All right, fellas, you got it.
We got it. I guess I'll just start it out. I know this is kind of normal, a little bit abnormal, because it's always been Brother Jack. And Jerry and Ray and them, they'd say, well, why don't you start this off? Sure glad to have Brother Raj. Sure glad. And we're, him and Dana both, the work that goes into this church is unbelievable. I think we all know that. Especially as deacons, we see what goes on. But something was on my mind this morning when Becky spoke. Let me tell you, Becky, we prayed for you for many years. Many years. You're so special to our church. But what you said this morning, it should pick everybody up. It should give them a better day. It should give them a better week. You know, because God's got control, and we're going to be down, and we're going to be up. But he'll pick us up all the time if we just go to him. Maybe you and Danny can come up. And you want to say something?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, you get up and say it.
I appreciate the church, number one. And that's the way it needs to be, God and the church. Yeah, and I appreciate all the work that you guys do. We went to the 100-year reunion thing over there briefly, a couple hours, a lot of us did. And it was a real neat thing to see. But the whole time I was there, I couldn't wait. Or I was thinking about heaven. There was a community over there, glad to see everybody. Yeah. Wanted to see the folks that had an impact in their life. And to me, I was thinking a lot about heaven and what it'll be like.
Amen.
100 years is no time. 100 years is no time. I came along, Brother Donnie, Pastor Jack, Gary, Pastor Gary, all these brothers have been the leaders.
Yeah.
And apparently the apple's not fell too far from the tree. But we're just so thankful for what you and Dana do and your entire family, and we love you.
Love you,
brother. Gary, I want to present you this song.
Put money in there.
Oh, my goodness.
I guess when I start talking, I start crying.
Yeah.
The love of the Lord, first of all.
Yeah.
Bless you. The Ben Winston family. Just like brother and sisters to the moon, we grew up so close.
Yeah.
And ever since I was led to the church a few years ago,
yeah,
I've just been so thankful. Because I know I have had the confidence in Brother Roger.
Thank you, brother.
And Sister Dana.
Yeah.
And Brother Donnie back here. In 1981. Had a revival with it. Him and Brother Buddy Kendrick, right?
Oh,
I gave my life to the Lord. Brother Donnie and him baptized me. And I've not always been the perfect Christian. I've made many of mistakes in my life. But I'm thankful that I always had the one that I could hold my
hand. Amen.
And ask for forgiveness. Right. And I see Brother Roger and the dedication that he has to this church and the love that he shows. I'm just so thankful for him. We love you. I hadn't been expected to get up here and say a word. I didn't know this was coming. But I love this church, and I'm thankful for each one. Brother Gary, that's a song many years ago. He was always faithful to come and preach at Belfry. All the preachers and the ones that have led this life for so many years, I'm thankful for each one.
Amen.
We love you all, and thank you.
We love you too.
I guess you're next.
I just want to say we love you all.
Thank you, brother.
We've had a hard year.
Amen.
Bless you.
Bless you.
Amen.
Oh, I sure are.
So much. We feel so blessed.
appreciate you all. I love you, everyone. Yeah, I love you, buddy. Yeah.
Thank you for you,
love
thank
you guys.
Thank you guys for what you do.
Yeah. Amen. I love you. I'm so thankful for you all. Love you guys a bunch. Listen, appreciate you. Donnie and Gary, I don't know that you, I know you never, you just knew to mind the Lord. I don't know, driving up and down this hollow and driving, I know you didn't see this day, and I know you probably didn't see me ever pastoring this church like this, but I am thankful for, the Bible says without a vision, people perish, right? God gave Gary Thacker and Donnie a vision. Donnie was our first pastor, and he's my uncle, and when they told me that Donnie was going to come and preach, I couldn't have imagined a better scenario. Donnie Williamson and Barb has been a part of everything in my life. Donnie married me and Dana. He gave the altar call at 11 years old when I was saved. When I was not doing the right things with the Lord, he preached on the prodigal son, and I come back and rededicated my life to the Lord. And here he is today. And for me to sit and to be a part of his life and what he means to me, Gary, Janet, I have not, this church, it's the best church that I could ever imagine anybody pastoring. Gary and Chelly, I thank you all for all you mean to this church. Chad, all the deacons, all your, everybody, I love you. And I'm looking forward to hearing the word of God today. Ain't you all? Yeah. I sure love you all. May God bless you. I thank y'all for my buddy here. Thank you all.
Amen. Amen. Very thankful for you guys. And let me just say this. I'm going to call her out this morning. Dana, I'm proud of you. I really am. You have done a fantastic job as Miss Pastor. And, you know, these women, they don't never hardly get much recognition, but she's come up with these ideals back here. The women are the ones that keep us in line. And I mean, that's the way it works. They're the ones that line us up and keep us going. When we fall apart, they're the ones that picks us back up. They encourage us. When we're wrong, they line us out. And I'm proud of you. You have done a fantastic job. And thank you, too. Thank you very much. All right. That singing took about 45 minutes. Brother Donnie, I hope you took your vitamins this morning, buddy. Come on up here. We're ready for you now. You guys sit much in prayer for Brother Donnie as he comes. You can't go hardly nowhere in southeastern, is that what this is called, southeastern Kentucky, until there ain't a Williamson, either a pastor or a preacher in a church somewhere. And they all come from this same family. So you guys pray for him this morning. Tickled to death. Glad to have you.
I thought once that I'd try to find a picture of Roger when he's a little bitty fella. When he had hair.
Oh my.
They were there. We've been together just about all his life. Danny's like my son. He stayed with Barb and I for a pretty good while one time under it. And I tell you, I don't feel like I can top what's over here, huh? But it's good to see all of you. So good to see Brother Gary and Sister Janet. I don't get to see them too often anymore. And do it now. Thank the Lord for them. Pray for me today. I'm just not able to do the things I used to do. Now, I hadn't taken a run in a long time. But Brad was in a revival over at Marbon, Kentucky. And I got over there and I got running and I told Brad not to tell his mom. But I do love the Word of God. I love you all. What you mean to me? I can't tell you all that unto it. So many good memories, Brother Gary. The way God's blessed us, the places we've got to be. I'll tell you, never dreamed that you'd have this kind of facility. Never did. But thank God for it today. And I said last time I was over here, I told them one time when I was back over in the other church, I said, now, this church will be here when Jesus comes. I said, I may be gone, and you may be gone, and all this, that, but the Canada Free Will Baptist Church will be here. Thank God. I have never saw a church grow like this one grew. Of course, we had a pretty good crowd to start with, didn't we? Yeah. I believe we had 69 people out the first service. Yeah. Now, I know that because that's why how many chairs we had. And they wasn't an empty one. Linda, Donna and Jamie the other day ran to it, and she was telling me, she said, our crowds have kind of down right now unto it. She said, we only had 60-some out. I said, my goodness, we don't see that many in two services anymore. You don't go to churches hardly that you find any kind of crowd anymore. And I'll tell you what, it's good to be an old-time Christian. Yeah. Good to know today that Jesus is still on the throne. Yeah. Praise his holy name today. I love him with all my heart. This past May the 3rd, I got 50 years I got to serve the Lord. And I'll tell you, it was a milestone. And I got to preach the Word of God for 48 years. And thank the Lord today. He's blessed me. Maybe not always the way that you'd like to be blessed, but God has blessed me. That's what I told Brother Brett a while ago onto it. I said, you know, these people say, if God blesses me, I'll preach. Yeah, that's true. But I said, all the times I've been preaching the Word of God, I've tried to study the Word of God, try to get a message on my heart. And I've never had to take a seat. You know what? And I've never had to sit back down. Brother, listen, God is calling. He may do it today. I don't know. But we got plenty of preachers in here to take over. Thank God. I'll not worry you patient very long. The message I'm going to preach on today could take a while, but I'll cut it short. I want to preach today, if God would bless me, on John 3:16. How many of you knows that today? Yeah. Oh, what rest of you don't know John 3:16? Lord, I'm preaching to a new crowd. Thank the Lord. But it says, God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have what? Everlasting life. If God will bless me for a little while today, and you may have heard a message somewhere before, but I want to preach to you today on the greatest story that's ever been told. Come on. Think about it. Think about it. The greatest story that was ever told. When I was in high school and in grade school, I loved to read books about people's lives. I always did love that. And this is the book about my God. And I'll praise his name today. Glory to God. I want to tell you, first of all, today, for just a few minutes today, brother, God is a way maker. And the things God's story, sometimes I forget a little bit anymore, children. Sometimes I forget a whole lot. And sometimes I just don't know it. But this message, the way I want to title it, The Greatest Man That Ever Lived. The greatest man that ever lived. My goodness, today, what we could preach on today just on that. We just preach strictly on that. I've tried to preach on the way, the truth, and the life, and I've never got past the way. Never have. And all the times I've tried to preach on that, I cannot get past the way. But God would come by when he came into this world. We know, we all know that God came into the world and he done everything while he was here that you and I could have come upon us. He's the greatest man that's ever lived. And this is the greatest story about him today. And he could come by. You know what? You couldn't have a funeral when Jesus was around. Do you know that? You couldn't have a funeral. to go by him, Father. Have to say, he'd stop and he'd raise the, at least three times in the Bible we read that. Have you ever met anybody that could raise the dead? If you know Jesus, you have.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise God forevermore. I'm about to feel like preaching today. Praise God. Told Buddy not too long before Brother Buddy died. Me and him preached together in a funeral down there, and I said, Buddy, I haven't heard you preach like that in many a years. He said, Brother, I ain't felt like that in many years. Amen.
Amen.
I like to feel it. Now,
yeah.
Let me tell you today, Brother. Brother Bobby Varney told him old Blue Springs one time. He told John Calvin, I reckon, he said, now, I don't have the message today, John. Don't call on me. I don't have the message. Guess what John did? He called on him. And Brother Bobby said, I'll tell you what. He said, I may not feel that I got the message. He said, but I've been in this thing long enough that I can get you one anyway.
Yes, sir.
Praise the Lord today.
Yes.
Hey, I love this word of God. Hey, I love the people that God healed, and I get a picture of them, what they looked like back then. It may not be a thing to it, but I can see them today. And one of my favorites is, Brother, that man that sat for 38 years at the pool. Now, he didn't say he had an infirmity, or he didn't say he sat at the pool 38 years. He had an infirmity of 38 years. Now, he may not sit there all that time. Might have been one of the newer ones that come. But can you imagine a place, Brother, that close by, that if they had a pool of water there that you could go, and once a year, about what it was, once a season, God would send an angel down to this pool, and Brother, it would ripple that water. I can see an angel with that old big hand going through it, the water starting to ripple, and Brother, what a run there was on the pool. Hey, listen, people laid there for a long time just trying to get paid. Jesus came by one day.
Yeah.
Praise God. First message I ever preached was then Jesus passed by. He's gone. How many times I preached it since, but I use it a whole lot. Jesus came by.
Yeah.
Praise God. Jesus walked up just where that man was laying. I don't know, had no cot, and it wasn't like just a cot, Brother, like you'd carry around the whole thing, but you could roll it up. And put it on his shoulder, he could. But he had never needed to do that. He wasn't able to walk. And Jesus walked up to him. You know what he said to him? Jesus looked at him. He said, "Will thou be made whole?" First thing he did is like everybody is before they get saved. Oh, praise God. It's always somebody else's fault. This man said, I don't have anybody, Lord. And when the water's troubled, but while I'm making my way down, somebody steps in ahead of me. Praise God. Today, I like this today. I'm going to tell you today, nobody can get ahead of you, Brother, with Jesus today. He's the one. He's the only one. He's the only way to heaven. God, I don't care how much money you get. I don't care how strong you are. I don't care how good you are. And by the way, just to say this, when people tell me, I ask them how they are, Brother Gary, and they'll say, good. I said, good. I said, I hope you are. But I said, I want to know how you are. Better be good. But anyway, that man sitting there, Brother, listen. And Jesus walked up and he said, will thou be made whole? Nobody to help me, Lord. Nobody. It's got to be somebody else's fault. Hey, praise God. Hey, a lot of people will probably say, now, you know, it's hard for me to stand still, children. Praise God forevermore. But I don't want nobody to get out of the earshot today. Praise God forevermore. Hey, listen to me today. And the man said, I have nobody, Lord, that while the water's troubled, somebody steps in ahead of me. But praise God. Now, Jesus told him, I didn't ask you. I tell you, he didn't go and say it in the Bible, but I believe he said, I didn't say, Brother, listen, do you want to do this or that? He said, do you want to be whole? You know what Jesus did to him? Praise God. Sometimes when I preach this, I get down on the floor.
Yeah.
But man, can you imagine this today? Brother, listen, Jesus told him, he said, take up your bed and walk.
Yeah.
If he hadn't have took up the bed, he would never have walked.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
But let me tell you what it is. He took that bed up, rolled it up on his shoulder, and my wife, we got a niece and a nephew that had been crippled ever since he was born. They went to be with the Lord the other day. Thank God for that. Never had took a walk one of them. Had never took a step. 50, about 50 of them. But then, where am I at? Let me get back here. Take up your bed and walk. Now, I can just see this old fella. He got over to the side of that bed, had to scoot off with his hands, got over there to it, legs about that big around, brother. Listen to me. And when he got off that cot, you know what happened? When he took that cot up and rolled that thing up, when he got on his shoulder, you know what happened? Brother, them legs started growing. Yeah. Glory! Yeah. I could just see them coming out, brother, while he was there. Oh, but you know what? This was on the Sabbath day. There's a bunch of Pharisees everywhere you go, in order. Still got a lot of them. Brother Delbert McCoy, a lot of times when he has an anointing service, Brother Delbert will say, if there's any Pharisees in here, I'd like for you to step outside for just a minute while we have prayer. Hey, I never thought about something like that, but I think it's a pretty good idea. Them, most of them non-believers, they're not going to help you in there. Brother, praise God forevermore. When he got that shoulder rolled, could you see him? Could you see him when he got up? At least 38 years, if he'd ever took a step. Oh, somebody said, I tell a story sometimes. I remember my pastor in Columbus telling, he said this big, fine, big old church, everybody's quiet. Nobody didn't say nothing. He's the only one done any talking. And the Lord came. They said he got up front of there. And he said, now, don't get all excited or nothing, but I just want to tell you, the Lord's come. We're going to stand up and file out, single file, all we go out here. I said, he better not get in my way. Amen. Praise God. I believe I'll run to heaven. I'd like to preach to heaven. Amen. Not be up there preaching, but preach my way up. But Jesus came by. Healed that man. What's the reason? If you're here not saved, what's the reason you're not saved? What's your reason today? Well, I got intentions of it. Brother Curtis Wellman says the road to hell's paved with good intentions. Amen. I tell people, talk about, oh, this fellow's so good and this and good and that. I said, he probably never spent a night in jail. But he'll spend a night in hell, brother, listen, if he don't get right with God. It's not what you've done that keeps you out of heaven, brother. It's not you. It's because you won't accept the Lord Jesus Christ. It ain't because you're a drunk. It ain't because you're a murderer. It ain't because you're a liar. Brother, let me tell you that. It's because you won't believe God. Simple, brother. A brother said a while ago when he's up here, it's not a complicated way, brother. It isn't. Anybody that wants to go to heaven can go. As I told that preacher in Columbus when he's sitting in my living room, and he listened to me a while. Brother Gary didn't tell this story. But he asked me, I cried a water bucket full of tears. But he asked me, he said, how do you feel? I said, I don't know. My mom was a Christian 56 years. And I didn't know how to get saved when I was 32. And after we got talked for a while, he looked at me, he said, you sound to me like you'd like to be saved. I said, I would, preacher. I am the Christian people. You know what he told me? If you want to be, you can be. Thank God. That's not complicated, is it? If you want to be a Christian, you can be a Christian. There ain't enough devils in hell to keep you from that. Praise God. You talk, when I walked out of my house that evening, I was going to play a ball game. When I walked outside, brother, the grass got greener. Hey, the leaves on the tree were greener. The flowers were prettier. You looking out with new set of eyes. You see a different world. And you know, I went on to play that ball game and I could care less about it. And I've told most of you in here before, I used to tell Barb, when I have to quit playing ball, just dig a hole, roll me in. But brother, I found something far beyond that. Glory to God. Thanks be to God. Well, I want to try to get through this a little bit. I'm feeling pretty good, though. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. Now, this man I'm talking about today, the greatest man that ever lived. Hey, listen, there wasn't nothing he couldn't do. I told you they couldn't have a funeral without him. Praise God forevermore, brother. Listen, he'd raise people up before they got to the cemetery, and some died before they got out of the room. Can't you imagine that day when Lazarus had been buried for 4 days? Jesus come, brother, listen, after they got him buried. You ever wonder why he waited until after they got him buried? Because if he'd got there, he wouldn't have died anyway. If he'd have come when Lazarus was just sick, he wouldn't have died. You can't have a funeral with him. You cannot. But he come to these two sisters, and that's what they try to hide. People's always got excuses. Always. Some reason why they're not healed, some reason why they're not saved, some reason why they don't do this or do that. Thank God today, brother. Listen, you got to step out once in a while. Amen. Now, let me get to another part of this right here. Greatest story ever told. Greatest life was ever lived. The greatest price that was ever paid. Amen. The greatest price that was ever paid for anything, brother, listen, that anybody wanted, was paid at Calvary. Yeah. He didn't have, you didn't have to go, you don't have to go get a loan to get saved. You know what? Everything, God gives you everything you got anyhow. You might work for it, but God gives it to you. My goodness, today, the greatest price that was ever paid. We could go back and read all this, and we could have preached it all out, but I won't say this. I'm going to try to get through these two real quick. The greatest price. Didn't use dollars. The greatest price was Calvary. That's the greatest price that's ever been paid. Jesus, the God himself, in the Garden of Eden, or in the Garden of Gethsemane. He himself prayed, brother, listen, till his sweat became as great drops of blood. Somebody said, it just as that, it was that. I read a doctor's account of Jesus' death. He said, you can agonize so bad, you can absolutely agonize so hard that your pores will sweat blood. Jesus, that night, he knew what was coming. 33 and a third years old, he knew why he'd come. He didn't come, brother, listen, to just bless everybody. He came to die for sin. Some people said, boy, I wish he hadn't had to do that. If he hadn't have done it, you wouldn't be saved. Amen. Oh, but as he hung there, and I always think about it, as he hung there, and I get a picture of it. Him hanging there, and his arms is nailed up here at the top of his hands, and his feet down at the bottom. And all that weight was on his hands. He'd get so tired holding himself up with his feet. Until he'd finally have to drop down onto his hands again, lay rest his feet just a little bit. He had process. Hey, bless God today. I'm talking about something, brother, money can't buy. I'm talking about something money can't steal. Nobody could, brother, could do what Jesus done for us. No wonder it's the greatest story he's ever told. No wonder today, brother. Listen today. We forget sometimes what God has done for us. Yes, but Lord, God's been, he's been better to me. I believe he has anybody. I really do, brother. Hey, praise God. I'm almost 83 years old. I've seen quite a few people in my time, nothing that I did but preach the word, but I've seen quite a few souls come to the Lord. I've been blessed in my Christian life. I've been blessed to be with some of the best people. I believe I had the best preachers I ordained of anybody in this county. I really do. And I thank God for every one of them. One time it was five of them pastoring. Thank God, still got three, four, still got four. My son Brad, Roger, Bill Mosley, and who was the fourth one? All right. Anyway, there's five of them. But Jesus died, as those people stood by the crosses there, as they stood by and they see what was going on. Let me tell you today, it wasn't. We think of it, we try to paint it up. You know this, and we put you know, off the cross here. But let me tell you what, we've got one over Leckyville sends in our baptistry, and it's varnished up real pretty. Got a light around it and all this and that. Hey, let me tell you, that wasn't the way that cross was. It was an old tree, brother, cut down, maybe tied across this way. Yeah. Listen, and when Jesus, let me describe what it's like to him, and I'm going to quit here just in a minute. As he went there on that old tree, could you imagine the bark? His back had been beaten with stripes, children, all over it. The blood had dried on his back, no doubt. And he would get so tired whenever he would be on his feet for a while, he would push up. And when he did, his back went right up that old bark of that tree. And then when he come back down, same thing. This was a horrible, horrible death. But he was doing it because he loved me. That's what's supposed to be personal. I said he did it because he loved you. But he did it for me because he loved me. Now, if you love him, he'll do it for you too. Amen. Then, finally, after 6 hours on the cross. 6 hours. Not very long, is it? No, not very long. Try holding your hands out for a minute, just like this. Just to hold them. Sometime try it. See how long you can hold your hands out and your arms. 6 hours was a long time to hang on that cross. Finally, whenever they come around to break their legs, and it was a custom to break their legs. If they come by a certain time and they hadn't died, they would break their legs so that they would die quicker. When it came to Jesus, he was already dead. Already dead. Back in, I believe it's back in Psalms, it says it wouldn't be a bone out of place. No, nothing was going to be broke. And then they took him down off that old cross, put him in a borrowed tomb. He didn't have the money with him to buy a burial place. Do you know that? He couldn't went down the road and bought a cheeseburger. This is God. I'm talking about God. When we get serious enough to realize God was doing this for us. Jesus was God in the flesh. But then they begged his grave. You know the story. Took him down and put him in the tomb. Laid him in there because it was on Friday and he was in a hurry to get it done. Anyway, They'd done what they could with the body real quick. And on Sunday morning, the women were going back to the grave. They were going to anoint his body more than something. But when they got there, the song was rolled away. As they went down, as they talked on their way down, they were wondering, who's going to roll the stone away for us? How are we going to get in here on that? They had faith. They were going to do it anyway. When they got there, stone was rolled away. Jesus couldn't find him. He was gone. These women all left at Mary Magdalene, and all of a sudden Jesus came out and spoke her name, and when he did, she recognized him. Now, I don't know exactly how it was open. I don't know how the rock was rolled away. But I know it was rolled away. And Jesus could have done it himself. I don't know. But it could have been a bunch of angels come down to it. I don't know. But they were so scared of him in that grave, they had 16 soldiers guarding that tomb. Why are you going to guard a tomb for? If they didn't believe that dead man was going to get up, why did they do that? Amen. Praise God. Real quickly now. The greatest gift that was ever given. Greatest gift that was ever given. And that's what salvation is. It's a gift. What, you know what it takes for a gift to be made, for to give a gift? You know what it takes? Three things. First, you got to have something to give. You got to have somebody to give it. And you got to have somebody to receive it. And until then, it's not a gift. Somebody can give you something. If you don't receive it, it's not a gift. Jesus was given that for you and me. It's the greatest gift that was ever given. Praise His Lord. Hey, I could preach how to, but I'm going to quit. I'll come back, maybe get back into it again sometime. Lord willing. Praise the Lord. I feel pretty good today. Come on, Brother Barry. Praise God.
You guys heard it as church, let's stand. Let's get our singers to come and get a song. The greatest story ever told from the greatest man who ever lived about the greatest gift that was ever given today. And you've heard it here today, this morning, a wonderful message about the love of Jesus Christ. I want you to think about that this morning. Brother Gary, would you care to come up here and stand? Brother, would you, if you're able? Would you care? These men are going to stand here in front of this altar today because they love you so much and they would love to pray with you today. If you think this morning that you don't have a relationship with Jesus Christ, and I say a relationship because I don't care a thing about religion. Religion is a thing where you show up and you go back home unchanged. But a relationship, that's something different. But this greatest man who ever lived, he left heaven and all the riches of glory to live a life like you and I so that he could know exactly what it was like to be like you and to feel like you, to have want and to have hurt. And yet he did it without sin so that he could be the sacrifice for your sin this morning. Would you come today and pray?
You don't have to know it all, God, just that you're not saved today.
You know, this morning, maybe you think, I am a Christian. I was born in Pike County, or my mom and dad was a Christian. I've been going to church my whole life, so I'm already a Christian. But let me tell you what, if you have never confessed Jesus Christ as your Savior, if you've never been brokenhearted about your sin and fell down and said, God, please save me, a sinner, then you're not a Christian this morning. You're just a good old boy or girl. I know you try to do your best today, but it takes that confession. It takes that confidence in knowing that God is the only one that can save you. It takes you to know that. So this morning, if you've never done that, guess what? I hate to tell you, you're not a Christian. But you can fix that today. I don't care if you're 8 or 88 this morning. You've got chance and opportunity here today to call out to God and say, God, please forgive me of my sin. And the Bible tells me He's faithful and just to do that this morning.
Thank you.
We're going to continue to pray for you. We are. We've been praying for you, and we're going to continue. You got over 100 years of people living for God right here, standing in front of this altar this morning. People serving God for 100 years of combined between these three guys. I know it. Do you think they'd do that if there wasn't something to it? Do you think that these fellas right here? Amen. We love you this morning. Now, we're glad for you here. We don't want you to go away. We got food over next door. This is a good part. We want to fellowship with you. If it's your first time here, please don't leave. Just go next door. There's ladies over there. We'll give you chicken or whatever they got. They're waiting on you to come. And we'd like for you to go be with us. We're thankful once again. Now, I was talking about Dana and her little boxes back here. Us guys, we had this thing, a big bowl. We'd just go around and say, put your money in it. But she came up with this idea, and we got two little boxes back here on the back to put your offerings in. If God puts it on your heart to give an offering, then you give it. Give it freely and with a cheerful heart. If you ain't cheerful, just keep it in your pocket. We don't want it anyway. That's the truth. We got two more boxes back here by the doors, and you're all like, here we go again. It's them people trying to get our money. This money, we take it, belongs to God. We're going to turn around and give it away. We don't put it in our pot. We don't get none of it. We're going to turn around and give it away. Food baskets are coming up. The holidays are coming, and you all know that people got it tough. So if you got extra change, them two by the doors, that's the money we take up, and we go out and we buy food baskets for people during the holidays. We'd love for you to have to do that for us this morning. Any other announcement? Miss Henson, will you got anything? Ladies' dogs early tomorrow at 6. 6. All right, so that's two weekends in a row you get stuff. Yes, absolutely. So come back. Okay. Yes. The card ministry, Jackie takes care of that. If you want to be a part of that, let her know. It's a big deal to let somebody know that you're thinking about them that's not here this morning. Barb Wells, yes, absolutely. Didn't see her here this
morning.
Revival on the 8th. Yep.
Well, I don't think I'm going to be able to. I talked to Lee about it.
Yeah. So there are going to be lots of good preachers there, and I saw some singers, going to be lots of good singers. If you want to go down to Lackeyville, they'd love to have you. They'll treat you just as good as we do here. I promise you, I've been there this morning. So if that's all, we love you guys so much. Let's all bow our head. Brother Gary, would you care to dismiss us and ask the blessing?